Hey guys, what's up? This is Sierra. We're still here in the end. Kind of scared to start transitioning over to our Firelands base. I think we're gonna have to gather up some endstone to make a bridge across, so give me just a second here. That's what we're gonna do for the start of this episode. Go ahead and get some endstone, and then we will get started on making our way over there. So, let's get to work. So I got the endstone, I made a bridge across to the mainland, or what I'm seeing as the mainland right now. I do have a problem though, and that is that I don't have any ender pearls. Yeah. I tried throwing it into the portal, and it just didn't take it. It didn't work, so I think I have to throw myself into the void. I'm glad I didn't bring that much stuff with me. This is a little bit depressing, or, I mean, maybe I should die to an Enderman, that way I don't lose my armor, but I guess it doesn't matter that much since it's just iron armor. I don't know. What is the best thing? Drop my stuff, and then jump into the void, right? That way it's not completely lost. Wow, I am not the brightest. Let's go ahead and do that. And it's scary time. Here we go. I'm not forgetting anything, right? No. Okay. A one. A two. A skiddle-do. Bye. What a nice place to wake up. A much less threatening, comforting place. We're gonna need some more food. I got some apples here. I don't think I need fortune for anything. But let's head back out there. I'll bring some more bread with me just for kicks, and we will try this again. Huh, it still put me on top of the roof again. Yeah, we might have to just rebuild this thing. I mean, there's no harm in making it bigger, but, this ain't working. But, for now, we're not gonna do that, I guess. Or should we? Should we spend this episode remaking this building? Making it a lot more cozy? I don't know. I guess it couldn't hurt. I just don't know if I feel like doing that right now, or if I want to just head on in there. Maybe we'll save redecorating this for the next episode, because we did just build this, and it looks really nice, and I would hate to tear it down, like, right now. I think I'll leave it up, even though it is a little bit inconvenient for the moment. We're still gonna leave it. So, let's get our important things here, and we are gonna start moving. We are going to actually do this now. So I'm gonna put on my armor, I'm gonna put my pick here, and we're gonna pick up the shulker box, which we have full of trees. Do we have all the saplings we need? We have one spruce sapling, we have two oak saplings. Do we have oak? No, those are super important. I need to get those real quick. Hang on just a second. I was so confused here for a second because I went over here and there was like two dirt blocks with two dark oak saplings and I couldn't figure out why. And then I remembered, oh yeah, Endermen, they do stuff like that. I didn't think about this, them moving my trees. So gonna have to be a little cautious of that. I think as long as I put the dirt underneath things, because we're gonna have a finite amount of dirt with no way to get more of it out while we're out here, we'll be okay. But that being said, I only have one spruce sapling right now, which is a little scary. Oh wait, nope, I have some more. Okay, so we will take these with us and gather up this dirt, and then otherwise I think we're ready to go. So about to make the scary transition. And we'll have to figure out exactly where we want to settle and everything. Okay, so let's pick this up. And take some more dirt. Take this, I guess. Always good to have more torches. I think we're okay on everything else. I guess I want my bow. Can't hurt. Even though the only thing we're really going to see out here are Endermen. I actually don't need my bow, do I? Huh. Okay, so this is the time. This is the moment. We're going to go to the Firelands with all of our stuff. Woo! I thought I was falling for a second. I got so scared. Okay, we're good. We got our stuff over here. Now we just have to walk over to the mainland. Oh, and I dropped everything here. Right. Okay, and I've got everything. Yeah, we're good. So we're just gonna not look at these Endermen. We're gonna pretend like they're not there. And we're gonna walk right over. We should be good. I hope there's. Wow, there's actually a lot of them over there. I almost looked at them without thinking. There's a lot of Endermen. So, it's gonna be hard to navigate this, but I think that we should either live on this mainland, like this island, or one that's near it. I don't know. I guess it would be fine to live here. Should we make a map here? I think we should at least make a map here. So let's kind of sit down for a second and do that. Let's go ahead and make a map. Actually, oh, we can't make a map. We need sugarcane. I forgot. So we will have to settle down before we do that. So let me make note of my coordinates where I'm at right now, just so we don't get lost. We're at 722 and negative 750. Okay. So let's see. I actually really like the look of this area over here. Doesn't this just look like a place that you would want to build a house? Because there's just this secluded little hill with all these chorus plants. I think this spot will be good. It's still attached to the main island, but it's far enough away where it kind of feels like we're out on our own and we'll be elevated. Yeah. We should just build a house right up here, and then we'll have like a big sugarcane farm and everything. I think this will be good. Oh, it goes even further. Wow, this is a big island, now that I think about it. Yeah, I think building right in the middle of this is gonna be pretty smart. I think this will be good. So let's get started on making a base. I think this should be pretty simple, but let's set our stuff down just to be safe, because I don't want to lose anything. Like, let's say I randomly look at an Enderman and I randomly die. That would be very sad. So I don't want to walk around with all this valuable stuff here. All right. Don't really need any of this right now. So, I guess the first thing we should do is plant some trees, right? Because we need lots of resources to build this. We're gonna need a lot. So, what should we make a tree farm? We could just make a little one right here. So let's put some dark oak here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Let's make them five apart just to be safe. And 2, 3, 4, 5. Right there. That should still grow. We'll clear this out just to be safe. Okay. So we'll have three dark oak. That should be good. You guys better leave this alone. This is mine. And then we'll put a little torch there. And they won't take the saplings, right? That would be really sad if they did. I don't know if they will or not. But for now, we're just gonna have two until we get some more saplings. And that should be good. Okay. And then as far as spruce is concerned, spruce is gonna be really, really big. We'll put it right here. Or spruce is gonna be really tall anyways. They're usually not that wide. Okay. We need four of those, and we only have enough saplings for one, so we'll just put that there and let it do its thing for now. And oak is the easiest for sure. I think to ensure that we get really tall trees, we'll do it like this. Right? 1, 2, 3. I guess three apart. Should they be farther apart than that? I don't know. Whoa, that's not what I meant to do. It's gonna look weird having oak trees right next to the chorus trees. But yeah, that should be good. We'll just put that like that. and we'll give everything a little bit of time to grow. In the meantime, let's get started on making our actual house. Oh, I almost looked at the Enderman. That would have been so bad. Okay, so we're gonna put our dirt away. And let's clear out this top level. I don't know what happens when you touch these things. I've never touched one of these chorus thingies ever, and I'm a little bit scared because we all know that the Nether and the End like to do stupid things such as make you explode when you try to sleep in them. So does that mean that I'm gonna die if I touch this? Nope. Oh, it came down like bamboo. Now I know what these are. These are chorus fruits. I don't know what you can use them to make. I know that if you eat one, you teleport a little bit like an Enderman, so I guess the implication is that the Endermen eat these. Just kind of a weird thing, but I think it's kind of cool. And I do like their color, it's really nice. Alright. So, we're gonna be making this house, kind of similar to how we made the treehouse to get in here. It's gonna be made of end stone, or like end brick, whatever. Spruce and dark oak. Oh look, we already got a dark oak tree, cool. Oh, it grew inside of the chorus plant? Okay. Boop. That's so funny. Alright. So we can eat these to sustain ourselves, right? But since we have like seeds and stuff, we can actually just make a farm. I think that's what we're gonna do. But let's go ahead and get started on laying out the framework of the house and just see how that goes. I have my pickaxe here, which I'm gonna need to repair that soon. I did not bring enough iron to make an anvil, so we will have to go back for that here in a second. But let me at least place this here. So let's see. So the way back to the main world is over there. So I think having this house face that and make it look really cozy is a good idea. Let's say that we want the main square of this house to start there. And let's have it be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Let's have it be that wide. 11. Should be good, and then a little bit longer, so let's make a rectangle. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Yeah. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I guess I can just go like this. Where is it? Right there. Okay. I think I want it to be a little bit longer than that. It doesn't look quite rectangular enough. I like the idea of having like a big log cabin in here, and I'm not going to change my building style at all. I want this to just be a cozy cottage in the middle of the End. It might sound like a crazy idea, but I think it's going to be really cool. Okay, and then I have this vision for a little side room here, which let's go 1, 2, 3, like that. 1, 2, 3. So my problem right now is I really need some more spruce wood, but these are not growing too fast. We might have to go back for a minute and get a little bit more supplies. And I think what I'm gonna do is while we are heading back, oops, I actually didn't mean to do that. We're gonna get a couple of things to make life out here easier. And then we will start working on the walls of the house. I'm gonna get an anvil, and I'm also gonna lay some rails, or try to make transportation out here easier. So bear with me just a second here, guys, and I will take a quick trip home, and I'll be right back. Okay, so I got some stuff, probably not as much stuff as I wanted or needed, but I did get some stuff. And I placed two more large spruce setups over here, and this middle one did grow, and boy oh boy, this tree is here just in time for Christmas. If I was gonna pick one spruce tree that looked like it was ready for me to take it home and put it in my living room, it would be this one, but boy, I also would not have room for this because this is a giant tree. So we're gonna repair axe real quick. Assuming... Actually, no. How would we do that? We don't have any levels. Ah, oh, I didn't think about this! Okay, we might just have enough axe durability to do this. I don't know, 40? What do you guys think? Do you think we have enough? We're gonna try it and see where we get here, so... Wish me luck, I guess. I'm not gonna break this axe. I'm not gonna allow that to happen. Okay, yeah, we definitely did it. 18. So, we had some leftover. We're okay. I will get some more experience to repair that. I just honestly don't want to do it right now. I don't feel like it. So, let's just continue building here and try to use our axe as little as possible. And I know for sure I want to go ahead and take some spruce like so. And I want to start making inner walls. So this is where the front door is going to be. It's going to be on this side. Let me see if I can figure out what the center is. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 4, 5. It's an odd center. Okay. Yeah, I guess that's fine. But we're going to have a door that goes right here in this place. And so we'll probably, I'll have to break that with the axe. I wasn't thinking. Let me get that real quick. Okay. And we are just gonna put a stair there, stair there, stair there. And I'm gonna have this, the inside of the house is gonna be one block lower than the outside ground is. Just because even though we have it on top of a hill, I think homes are really inviting when you can step down into them and feel like you're inside of something. Especially in Minecraft, I really like that effect. I don't know if that makes sense or not, but maybe it will after I get all of this built. I'm gonna pick up these saplings here just so they don't despawn. I do not want to lose any spruce saplings out here. Okay. So, let me go all the way around with this, and we will start working on stacking the walls some more. So hang on just a second. Alright, so now I gotta think about how I want all of this to be framed. So if this is where the door is, maybe we have, like, a border here? No, because that only leaves two blocks for the windows. I think one more in like that would be good, and then we could have a window that's like either, oops, we could have one that's either one or three blocks. So let's put that like that. I don't know if what I'm saying makes sense or not, but so we're gonna go like this, and yeah, I think we're just gonna stack it up like so. And can you make stairs and stuff out of end stone? If you can't, that's silly. And it should be changed, but oh no, you can. That's very cool. Oh, I think I brought a stone cutter. Does that work with end stone? I hope it does. So I'm gonna take this. Yeah, okay, that's very cool. Just got like 10 of those. I don't think we'll need a lot of them. And that's, should I use regular end stone for an accent like this? Would that look good? And then just have it be like that? I don't know. I think it looks better when it's just bricks, because it looks like it's an actual, like, masonry style house. I think that looks better. Yeah. And then we're gonna stack it up here. I don't know how tall I want this house to be. We'll have a window here, which I think we're not gonna put a stair there. We're just gonna have it at this level, and that'll look good. One thing I could do though is I could take this out and then put stairs here, and that way the window looks a little more inviting from the inside. So then have panes like that. Yeah, I think that looks good, and then it looks like a little seat as well where you can sit by the window. I think that's cool. Okay, so more bricks there. Same thing here. We'll chop this out, put stairs in. Hello? That sounded really weird. Enderman stepping on wood. I don't know. 2, 3. Okay. So that looks pretty cool so far. I definitely like this. And then we want this to be stacked up. Okay. Now I don't know what I want to do when we get this to the height that we want it to be. I want it to be at least 3 blocks tall. So that means that the whole wall is going to be 3 blocks tall, because we are going to put stairs on top of this. So that means this will be 4 blocks? Maybe it should be 5. I don't know. I'm not sure. I think, yeah, having it like this will be good. And then put stairs facing out like this. Does that seem tall enough? I think it's kind of short. I think it should be a little bit taller. I think it would look better if it was at least 4. Because I want this to be a house that you can see from kind of far away. I think that would look good, especially because it's going to be sort of strange to see a house here in the end, you know? So I want it to really stand out, and people, like, theoretically you would look at it and you'd be like, oh wow, that looks so inviting. And it'll be glowing from the lights inside of it and just look really, really nice. So if we do it like this, this will be 5 blocks tall, which I think should be sufficient for what I want to do. So this is the front of the house, which is kind of a staple or example of the design that I have in my head so far. And I still think this is going to look really good. So I think that the cyan panes were a really good idea. I think they complement really well with the warmness of the rest of the materials. And I added one little one here, just kind of embedded into the wall, which I think gives this area a lot of definition. I was really struggling trying to figure out how I could have like an overhang or something that would come out and you walk in and then you come through this front door. But I figured that, you know, since it's just a 3-wide area, it's kind of hard to add that amount of detail. So I just, oh, okay, that scared me. I accidentally moved my mouse. It's hard to add that kind of detail, so I think this little window helps a lot. And then, of course, I just added some lanterns and some little bits of detail here. But obviously, if you go in the house, it's not an actual house yet. This is just a wall, and we have to add a roof and everything like that. So I think this looks pretty good so far, and I hope it gives you guys an idea of what I am aiming for with the overall design. So I actually think we're gonna go ahead and wrap things up for today. I'm really happy with how this is coming along, and I'm also being really careful right now not to look at any Endermen. That's the thing about being in the end now. Whenever I do my third person thing, I have to be real careful that there's no Endermen in front of me, because I'm pretty sure that I could still anger them if I did that. So gotta be real careful. But yeah, if you guys did enjoy, please leave a like, comment, subscribe, consider sharing with maybe one of your friends. That would help me out a whole lot. And I'm also going to be streaming tomorrow, Friday and Saturday. Not quite sure what I'm going to be doing. I think I'm going to be playing with friends at least one of those streams, and then the other one will probably just be like a chill Minecraft stream and we'll play in our Twitch world. I don't know, things could change, but definitely streaming Friday, Saturday, tomorrow, and the next day, from 3 to 9 p.m. Eastern time. So if you guys want to watch that, check me out on Twitch, link in the description. And I hope you guys have a great day. I will see you guys in the next one. My name is Sierra. Bye-bye!